Hello everyone, this is Erik, the Asian movie enthusiast, and this is my review of Pale Moon, a Japanese drama romance from 2014 that was directed by Daihachi Yoshida, the man who also directed Funuke Show Me Some Love, You Losers, a film that I reviewed on my channel a few weeks ago. Now, Pale Moon is set during the mid-1990s, and this is important to note because there was an economic bubble in Japan from the late 80s to the early 90s, and basically what that means is that the real estate and the stock market prices were inflated and overvalued for a time. Now, this price bubble collapsed in 1992 and caused a lot of financial hardship that lasted decades. In fact, I think the 1990s in general is considered the lost decade, so to speak, by many people when referencing Japan's economy as a whole. So Pale Moon takes place only a few years after that major event. So living under the stifling responsibilities of society, a married woman in her early 40s decides to embezzle funds from her elderly bank clients for the purpose of funding her young lover's school tuition, as well as paying for their expensive weekend rendezvous. Now, the bank that she works for provides door-to-door service, where the bank employee will visit an elderly person's house and help them with their deposits, withdrawals, or investment advice. Now, I read somewhere online that this was an actual business strategy by some banks after the bubble burst. Probably, they provided this home delivery service to, probably to help with public relations, to reach out to their customers, and even in some cases grow their business through word of mouth. The protagonist in this film decides to work the system for the purpose of pocketing some of that cash for her own pleasure. Now, similar in some ways to the Japanese film I covered earlier this week, Sword of Doom, we have a protagonist who engages in some reprehensible activities. And just like Sword of Doom, Pale Moon somehow makes it work. It somehow makes it interesting. Now, in this case, I think one reason why it works is that the characters' frustrations in life are understandable. They really are. I mean, her marriage is extremely stale. Her husband seems like a decent dude. He treats her okay. He's not rude to her or beats her or anything. But all of his actions just seem to be very lifeless and obligatory. You know what I mean? So much so that you can tell that there is no passion left in their marriage at all. Her boss is a slimy jerk. So obviously, cheating on your husband and stealing from people's, bank accounts is obviously not the response to these kinds of problems, but you can definitely feel and understand her frustrations. Another reason why this film works is the lead actress, Rie Miyazawa. I covered her already when I reviewed Her Love Boils Bathwater on my channel, but she was also the lead actress in Toni Takatani, a film that I would also recommend that I have not yet reviewed. I really like this actress. In Pale Moon, she has the difficult task of playing a person who is not the least bit apologetic for her immoral actions, but she is somehow able to give a performance that makes the viewer kind of root for her. You know what I mean? I gotta be honest with you. I was hoping at some points in this film that she would not get caught. I mean, it's kind of hard to explain. I mean, I practically had fun watching her do some of these things. So if someone can draw you in that well with their performance, they're very good at their profession. So I look forward to watching whatever she has been in and whatever she will be in the future as an actress. But that's one thing that some viewers may have a problem with. Okay, this film is very non-judgmental regarding this woman's actions. To be fair, they do show most of the face-to-face meetings with the elderly victims, who have no idea they're getting conned, out of their money. And that does help to accentuate the fact that she's doing bad things. But I definitely sense that the film was also portraying her actions in almost a romanticized kind of way. But regardless, I found that angle to be interesting and even a bit edgy. So it was something that I actually enjoyed about the film. There's a bit of workplace politics in this as well that's blended into the story, especially regarding the slimy boss and the older woman at the bank who runs a very tight ship. There's this lady at the bank who's very by the book. So that causes problems for the main character in trying to, do these shady dealings without her noticing. Some other shady stuff is going on at the bank as well, as you'll see if you decide to watch the film. I do like how the film shows important little moments that are turning points for the characters. And it does not over-dramatize a lot of this stuff. You know, it accentuates them using subtlety. There's an underlying tension that is established because the protagonist and the viewer knows that everything will probably come crashing down at some point, so she attempts to delay the inevitable as long as she can during the second half of the film. But I will say that the ending is totally different from what I was expecting, and I kind of like that. Now, Pale Moon is a solid film overall. It is proficiently directed, written, and acted. There is some very good dialogue in this as well. The story flows naturally, and the character interaction develops in unexpected ways at times. Another very solid film by this director, Daihachi Yoshida. So yes, I definitely recommend Pale Moon. It is moderately available on Region 3 DVD with English subtitles. And as always, I will see you next time.